Students, this is a 2017 question paper asked for 6 marks. Okay, this is a very simple question. You can take your book and pen and please write this question in the book, and it will be helpful for you when I am doing on the board. Definitely it will be useful for you. Okay, now let us see how to solve this question. Guys, we will quickly read this question and try to understand the question, and we'll see what exactly is asked in the question. Glory Company Limited had a profit of ₹3,60,000 for the year ended 31st March 2015 after adjusting the following. So, after adjusting the following means in this net profit already they have added some of the things and deducted some of the things. Now what we have to do, which have already added, we have to minus it. Which have already deducted, we have to add it back. Okay, because after deducting means what? After adjusting means what? After plus and minus doing, we got a net profit of 3,60,000. Let us see what is the net profit given in the question. The net profit given in the question is ₹3,60,000. Now, I will write this net profit. See, this is the statement we have to prepare. And I will read out the complete question. Depreciation on machinery ₹30,000. Goodwill written off ₹10,000. Loss on sale of building ₹5,000. And details of current assets and current liabilities are given like this. Stock is given. Cash balance is given. Debtors, creditors, outstanding rent, bills payable, bills receivable. From the above, calculate cash flow from operating activity using indirect method. Now, what we try to calculate is cash from operating activity we have to calculate. Now, when we are calculating cash from operating activity, first what is required is net profit is required. And he is given ₹3,60,000 as net profit. And to that we need to add cash from operating activity. Plus and minus. Cash from not operating, it is a non-operating. Okay? Cash from non-operating expenses. Cash from operating activity. In that, non-cash and non-operating expenses need to be adjusted. Now, in this, first one is depreciation on machinery. See, depreciation on machinery, what how much is given is given ₹30,000, which I am writing in inner corner. Okay, guys? Okay. Goodwill written off. See, goodwill written off, preliminary expenses written off, here it is there. So, I am writing goodwill written off as ₹10,000. And loss on sale of buildings is ₹5,000. Loss on sale of asset here is there. I am writing ₹5,000 here. Now, there is no non-operating incomes. So, I am taking it as a dash. Now, let us understand the current assets and current liabilities position. Stock is from 2016 to 2017, it is increased. Stock is increased from 1,40,000 to 1,70,000. That means there is an increase in stock. Increase in current asset leads to increase in working capital. Right? Increase in current asset leads to increase in working capital. So, therefore, stock is increased by ₹30,000. I hope you understood. See, if the current asset increases, working capital also increases. So, therefore, I am taking it in the increase in working capital point. And cash, opening balance of cash is 1,30,000 and closing balance of cash is 1,00,000. which we don't write anywhere, because cash opening and closing will be adjusted at the end of the financing activity. So therefore, at this point of time, please don't take cash. Okay. Next is debtors. Debtors is, it is 1,10,000 and 90,000 rupees. There is a decrease of debtors to the extent of 20,000 rupees. If there is a decrease in current asset, decrease in working capital. Decrease in current asset, decrease in working capital. So the decrease in current assets is nothing but debtors. It is decreased by 20,000 rupees. From 1,10,000 to 90,000 it has happened. So 20,000 is decreased. Creditors is a liability, current liability. 90,000 in the beginning, 1,00,000 rupees in the end. At the end, that means there is a decrease in the current liability. See, if there is any decrease in the current liability, decrease in the current liability leads to increase in the working capital. So therefore, creditors 10,000 rupees and taking it in the increase in the working capital heading. Outstanding rent, this is also a liability. Rent outstanding means what? Rent payable. Rent payable 10,000 to 5,000. Again, there is a decrease in the current liability leads to increase in the working capital. Outstanding rent 5,000 rupees, I will take it here. Next, bills payable. Again, bills payable is a current liability. 80,000 to 70,000 rupees, there is a decrease in the current liability leads to increase in the working capital. So therefore, bills payable 10,000 rupees, I will take it under increase in working capital heading. Next is bills receivable. See, bills receivable is increased here from 90,000 to 1,10,000. That means there is an increase in the working capital to the extent of 20,000 rupees. So increase in current asset leads to increase in working capital. So therefore, bills receivable increase in the working capital column, I am writing as 20,000 rupees. So that's all about the adjustments given in this question. What we need to try to do here is, first we need to add non-cash, non-operating expenses. Say all remaining you can put dash dash items. Okay. And if you check the totals of this, all these are a plus, right? So I am adding it as a plus amount. 10 plus 30, 40, 40 plus 5 is 45,000. Now, this 45,000 add it to 3,60,000 and you will get 4,05,000 rupees. See, since this is also plus number, this is also plus number, you will get plus number here. Since there is no non-operating incomes, I am writing it as a nil here, and again I am getting 4,05,000 as a plus number. Okay. Now, decrease in working capital is in the plus number. So therefore, I am adding this as a plus number of 40,000. And plus is plus only. This becomes 4,45,000. Now, here, increase in working capital is in the minus symbol. So all these minus numbers we need to add. See, 30,000 plus 10,000, 40,000. 40 plus 5 is 45,000. 45,000 plus 10,000 is 55,000. Now, minus 55,000. Minus 55,000. Now, from this plus 4,45,000, if you deduct 55,000 rupees, cash from operating activity you will get is 3,90,000 rupees, and your answer is 3,90,000 rupees. See guys, this is a very simple format where you get 6 marks within no minutes when you understand the question. If you strictly follow with the format, I am sure you will get 6 marks from this. So this is a question which was given in the year 2017 for 6 marks. Okay? please make a note and understand and try to understand. Thank you.